outside the cafe by the cracker factory. You were practicing a magic trick, and my thoughts got rude as you talked and chewed on the last of your pick and mix. Said you're mistaken if you're thinking that I am being cold before, as you bit into your strawberry lace and offered me your attention in the form of a gobstopper. It's all you had left and it was going to waste. Your pastimes consisted of the strange, the twisted and deranged, and I loved that little game you had called crying lightning, and how you like to aggravate the ice cream man on rainy afternoons. The next time that I caught my own reflection, it was on its way to meet you, thinking of excuses to postpone. You never looked like yourself from the side, but your profile could not hide the fact you knew I was approaching your throne. With folded arms you occupied the bench like toothache, stood and puffed your chest out like you'd never lost a war. And though I tried so not to suffer the indignity of reaction, there was no cracks to grasp or gaps to claw. And your pastimes consisted of the strange, the twisted and deranged, and I ate that little game you had called crying lightning, and how you like to aggravate the icky man on rainy afternoons. Uninviting, but not half as impossible as everyone assumes you are. Crying lightning. Oh, you were reading a book about some idiot and telling me about another. I was so severely underwhelmed, I thought I might never recover. Straighten the rudder, girl, and sail me upstairs, and go and find somebody who cares. Well, we might not be the perfect partners, but tonight we make a pair. Your pastimes consisted of the strange, the twisted and deranged, and I ate that little game you had called crying lightning. Crying lightning, oh. Crying lightning. Crying lightning. Your pastimes consisted of the strange, the twisted and